Hi everybody! Have you ever noticed a small spark when you turn off a light? Or heard a little click when you turn off your car? This happened because a tiny component called an inductor. An inductor acts like a spring that stores electrical energy inside itself. Now imagine releasing this spring suddenly. What happens? Just like a spring, when we disconnect the current from the inductor, a very strong energy is released that can cause a spark or even damage other components. To prevent this, we use a diode. A diode is like a one-way valve for electricity, allowing the excess energy to safely escape without harming anything else. Imagine an inductor is like a large spring. When an electric current flows through the inductor, it's like compressing a spring. The inductor stores energy. Now, when we cut off the current, the spring quickly returns to its original position. This rapid movement of the spring creates a very strong force that can damage the surrounding components. In electronic circuits, when the current in the inductor is cut off, a very strong voltage is generated, which we call the induced voltage. This voltage can cause a spark or even burn the components. This is why inductors resist sudden changes in current. They try to keep the current flowing at the constant rate. This property of inductors makes them useful in many electronic circuits, such as power supplies and filters. Imagine an inductor is like a heavy flywheel. The faster you try to spin the flywheel, the more force you need to apply. Similarly, an inductor resists changes in current. The faster you try to change the current flowing through an inductor, the greater the voltage across it. When we use PWM to control the current in a circuit, the shape of the output waveform is affected by the inductor. This deformation is because the inductor cannot respond quickly to change in current. As the PWM frequency increases, the inductor becomes less able to respond to these changes, and the output waveform becomes closer to a straight line. This property of inductors makes them useful in many electronic circuits. For example, inductors are used in power supplies to reduce noise and create a smooth output voltage. They are also used in resonant circuits, where they are combined with capacitor to amplify specific frequencies. To practically observe the behavior of an inductor under a PWM signal, we'll build a simple circuit. This circuit will include an NPN transistor, like a D718. An inductor will use one from a car injector, a resistor to limit the base current, and a power supply. A function generator will be connected to the base of the transistor to generate a PWM signal. According to this circuit, I'll connect the oscilloscope to the base and the collector to observe the voltage at these two points in the circuit. I'll connect the ground clip of the oscilloscope to the ground. I haven't included the freewheeling diode in the circuit yet. First, I'll power the circuit without the diode, and then add the diode to see the difference. We set the input voltage to 5 volts. When we turn off the transistor, we notice a peak voltage of around 60 volts on the collector, which is much higher than our supply voltage. This phenomenon occurs due to the presence of the inductor in the circuit. The inductor acts like a small battery, storing energy in a magnetic field. When current flows through the inductor, a magnetic field is created around it. However, when the transistor turns off and the current is interrupted, this magnetic field collapses rapidly, releasing the stored energy as an induced voltage. Since there is no path for this energy to go, it builds up and according to the properties of an inductor, is converted back into electrical energy or voltage, appearing across the collector of the transistor. This is why we see a high voltage on the collector. Here, we've measured about 60 volts. Even though the input voltage is only 5 volts. If we apply a higher voltage, like 300 volts DC, as an switching power supply, this voltage spike can reach several thousand volts. If the transistor can't handle this voltage, it will definitely be damaged. To address this issue and eliminate sudden voltage spike, we connect a diode in parallel with the inductor. The anode of the diode is connected to the negative voltage, and the cathode is connected to the positive voltage. When the transistor is turned off, the induced voltage across the inductor forward biases the diode, allowing the current to flow back through the diode to the power supply. This way, the energy stored in the inductor's magnetic field is dissipated as heat in the diode, and some of it returns to the power supply. A portion of the energy might be restored in the inductor, and this process can repeat several times until the energy is completely dissipated. This prevents high voltage spikes and protects other components from damage. Now, let's add the diode to the circuit and see what happens. By placing the diode in parallel with the inductor, all the excess voltage spikes will be eliminated. That's why in circuits with inductors, we always place a diode in parallel with the inductor to protect other components from damage. When we remove the diode from the circuit, the excess voltage spike will reappear. It's important to note that the choice of diode is crucial. For high frequency circuits, it's best to use Schottky or fast recovery diodes, as they can switch at high speeds. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video informative.